Hypertension is defined as a systolic blood pressure greater than or equal to 130 millimeters of mercury, or a diastolic blood pressure greater than or equal to 80 millimeters of mercury, measured on two separate occasions. Hypertension is considered one of the leading causes of cardiovascular diseases. Lowering blood pressure does reduce cardiovascular risks. Maintaining a systolic blood pressure of less than 130 millimeters of mercury has been shown to prevent complications in patients with heart failure, diabetes, coronary artery disease, stroke, and other cardiovascular diseases. There are multiple classes of medications by varying mechanisms used to reduce blood pressure. Thiazide diuretics are one of the recommended classes used as the first line for the treatment of hypertension. They act on kidneys to increase urine production, therefore eliminating water from the body. The basic unit of the kidney is called a nephron, and each nephron is made up of a glomerulus, which filters the blood. The filtered content goes through the renal tubule, where excess waste and molecules, such as ions and water, are removed or filtered through an exchange between the tubule and the peritubular capillaries. The renal tubule has a few segments of its own: the proximal convoluted tubule, the U-shaped loop of Henle, and finally, the distal convoluted tubule, which empties into the collecting duct, which collects the urine. Thiazide diuretics act specifically on the distal convoluted tubule of the nephron. Thiazide diuretics are taken orally. Once in the blood, they travel to the kidneys, where they are secreted by the proximal convoluted tubule into the lumen of the renal tubule. They travel along with the filtrate until they reach the distal convoluted tubule. This part of the nephron is lined by epithelial cells. On the luminal side of these cells, there's a sodium chloride transporter. This channel reabsorbs one sodium and one chloride ion together from the tubule into the cell. Sodium is reabsorbed along with water into the interstitium and then into the bloodstream. Thiazide diuretics inhibit the sodium chloride cotransporter. By blocking the sodium chloride cotransporter, thiazide diuretics prevent the reabsorption of sodium from the urine back into the bloodstream. This increases sodium and water excretion in the urine and decreases blood volume. Decrease in blood volume reduces venous return. Decreased venous return decreases cardiac output, which ultimately decreases blood pressure. While thiazide diuretics are generally well tolerated and effective, they can have side effects. These usually stem from the ionic imbalance caused by the initial sodium loss in the distal convoluted tubule. Hypokalemia or low potassium level is a common side effect and can cause muscle weakness, cramps, and irregular heart rhythms. This happens because an increased concentration of sodium ions in the collecting duct makes it secrete more potassium and hydrogen ions from the blood and into the urine. These drugs tend to tamper with sugar and fat metabolism, causing hyperglycemia and an increase in blood cholesterol and triglyceride levels. Thiazide diuretics also cause uric acid to be retained in the blood. Chronic hyperuricemia could lead to gout. Additionally, thiazide diuretics are sulfa-containing drugs. Patients with sulfa allergies taking thiazides may experience headaches, rash, hives, swelling of the mouth and lips, wheezing or trouble breathing, asthma attack, and anaphylaxis. Thiazide diuretics are an effective and relatively inexpensive first-line treatment for high blood pressure. They are used in combination with other medications to treat more severe cases of hypertension. However, they should only be taken as prescribed by a doctor to ensure their safe and effective use. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.